Save the date, May 10th, for the third annual Senior Citizen. You're watching your local television network, TSPN. And now back to Today's Seniors Living Well with your host, Lori Webb.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Today's Seniors Living Well. This is our sixth series, and we're talking about how to empower seniors to keep them at home safe, healthy. Actually, next month is Older Americans Month, and that's its themes, helping seniors stay safe and stay healthy at home. And we have a lot of resources for that here in Amador County. And with me this morning are two of our wonderful resource brokers, have Wendy Mathis and Fleeta Herndon. Wendy's with United Home Care and runs the patient care services. And Fleeta is with United Personal Care, which is the kind of private duty arm of United Home Care. And I, you know, not a day goes by at the senior center that I don't get a call from, or Annie doesn't get a call from a family saying, you know, my mom just broke her hip, or my mom, you know, has congestive heart failure, or my mom needs help. And, you know, what do I do about getting someone in? And of course, the first question we ask is, are they on Medicare, or do they have insurance? Do they have a doctor? Does a doctor want them to have skilled care? And if the answer is yes, then we have them call Wendy at United Home Care. And what happens then?
So once we get a call from a family member or a physician, we take all their information, a little history about them. We get documentation from the hospital. We also communicate with the doctor when he'd like us to start care with them. You can expect a call from us. Usually when we get the referral, I make the phone call and mm-hmm. I'll talk to the family. Mm-hmm. If they are at a hospital, mm-hmm. If they're at our local hospital or Kit Carson, I go over there and I'll meet with the patient and meet with the family. And you can expect a home health nurse to be out to see you within 48 hours.
Usually, yep.
And often, depending on your diagnosis, it could also be the following day. Uh-huh. And we will run all the insurance and take care of that to make sure that the patient has benefits. And with private insurance, sometimes there's a copay. Mm-hmm. So I would call the family and the patient to make sure that, they know about that,
they're aware
and that they're okay
with that.
Which
I really appreciate, because I don't like to have to go in the home on a Saturday and say, oh, by the way, did you know you're going to have to pay X number of dollars a visit? It's really nice that you take care of all that. Now, besides nurses, there's other skilled services that are available.
Mm-hmm. We have skilled nursing, physical therapy, occupational therapy. We have medical social workers. We have a home health aide, speech therapy, and then we also have a dietitian.
And that's a very important thing, because we are seeing, I feel like we're seeing more dietary-related situations that need consultation.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
So how long can a patient expect to have skilled nursing in? Is there a set time?
There is.
Like, is it 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 9 weeks? I know I write my plans for 9 weeks, but...
It's up to 9 weeks, but mm-hmm. it really depends on how well the patient's progressing. Mm-hmm. So some people may only be on care for 3 weeks, mm-hmm. and some people may be longer. Just depends on how well they're doing. And so once the staff gets you back to your prior level of function, then they're going to close you to care.
Uh-huh. And because Medicare won't cover if there's not a skill in there.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think that... the old days when we used to stay in forever, you know, are gone for good. But I also see that people sometimes recover in less than 3 weeks. And, you know, we don't need to be in there with them.
Yeah, so. We are seeing a lot of patients now, joint replacements that mm-hmm. we're only seeing for like 2 weeks and they're, you know, ready to go to outpatient.
Right. And or I'll call them and I'll say, you know, I understand you got a hip replaced and, well, why do you need to come out? You
know,
I want physical therapy. And I'm like, oh, okay, we'll do that.
Yeah.
So then after they're close to care, sometimes they need more care.
Right.
And people will say, home health's not going to be here anymore. You know, what do I do? And I usually tell them that there's three components. There's, if they're low income enough, they can apply with the county for in-home supportive services. Mm-hmm. But if they're lucky enough to have long-term care insurance or good financial backing, or they really want to do this for themselves or their parents, then we have a number of private care agencies. And Fleeta, you run and have been at United Personal Care for how long?
Almost 2 years.
Two years. And it's been in Amador. We're, the, I think, the longest running.
Yes, to my knowledge, almost 20 years.
So
what we do is we will a lot of times talk with the home health company, and they'll tell us, or we'll just get phone calls, lots of phone calls, of need for personal care assistance.
That's true. They don't always come from the home health agency.
Right.
People like me or Annie might call you, or the family might call you.
Right. Yeah. Or the hospitals, or or just word of mouth. You know, that's a lot of it. So we'll, what we do is we go to the home and we do an assessment of the client to see what their needs are. And it can be anywhere from just companionship. They may be lonely and they just want somebody to come to the home and be there with them, maybe cook a meal for them, do a little light housekeeping, even up to assistance with dressing or bathing.
So it can be
shopping.
Everything from that much assistance, including like people that are bedbound and need help getting up to the commode and things like that.
Yes.
Just through just companionship.
Right. And we'll take them shopping or to doctor appointments, things like that.
You can take them out, huh?
Absolutely.
That's excellent.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, and we care for them anywhere from 4 to 24-hour time frames. So it gives them a lot of options that they, you know, don't always have available just through family or friends.
Right.
And a lot of times we see with folks is they don't want to ask their family. They say, oh, they're busy. They're, you know, we don't want to bother them. But we only need a little bit of help, you know, so we'll go out. And
you help people kind of, I know you've helped a couple families kind of untangle the long-term care insurance puzzle.
Yes.
Because, you know, 20 years ago there was no such thing, and now it seems like a lot of the baby boomers do have long-term care insurance, and but they don't understand quite how to use it. Or, and you guys are pretty knowledgeable about that?
Yes, we'll get on the telephone and talk with the insurance companies and encourage them to, you know, work with us to get everything all set up for them.
And your United Personal Care is also a qualified vendor with Del Oro Caregivers Resource Center.
Yes, we are, with Del Oro and with Area 12, Agency on Aging.
So that means that sometimes care can be underwritten by one of those agencies, and the people don't have to pay for the respite care. And the good news is Amador County Senior Center is probably going to be able to make another major grant to Del Oro to fund respite here in Amador County.
We
won't probably know for a couple months, but it's we're definitely planning to do that because that's such a wonderful service. So what do you do? Okay, so these are people that don't want to bother their family and they call you, or maybe don't want to have service, but if the doctor says they have to, they will. What do we do about people that say, don't want you, or that the daughter calls and says, my mom needs help, but she absolutely is refusing? Do you have suggestions for that?
Well, just, you know, if they'll even let us have a casual visit, that sometimes is just the in. You know, just, or even talking on the phone sometimes. I'll have long conversations with folks, and, you know, it takes sometimes, you know, 20 to 30 minutes, and they'll warm up and say, oh, okay, go ahead and come out. And then as long as they know they're not committed to something always, you know, they have an option to say, okay, no, don't come back.
They can refuse
open.
Services.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's something that sometimes surprises people even on the Medicare side. When I tell them, look, if you don't want us out here, well, my doctor, well, your doctor thinks it's a good idea, but hey, it's your decision.
It's always their choice. It is, absolutely. So. And that helps them feel much more comfortable to allow the visit.
Some control.
That's right.
And
that's
wonderful that you and I, does Cody go out and do assessments?
Yes.
Just go out there and charm
we
the pants
both
off
do.
Of them. Oh, if they're that nice, I'll be happy to have them in. And I know that you have a lot of really great women working for you.
Yes, over 31 right now.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing.
Yes. And the other thing that helps clients is to know that all of the staff that come to their homes, they're all background checked and, you know, for to make sure, because it's very scary to have somebody right. come into your home that you don't know.
Don't know. And that's the real advantage to using a mm-hmm. professional agency mm-hmm. like you all.
Right.
And we have about seven mm-hmm. agencies now, but I know some of them are based in other places. You're the
right.
only locally based
right.
agency.
Right.
But I know that a couple of the others are starting to take a little of the burden off of you, too.
Yes.
And then I have my list, or we have our list at the Senior Center, and I counted the other day, I have 142 people on that list.
Wow.
But of course, they only are willing to work certain places, and
mm-hmm.
they're not background checked.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And yes, they might be a little less expensive, but they don't get the training or the right. supervision that
right.
your staff gets.
Right.
So.
And that's very important.
Yeah.
Because that's another thing, the staff, they go through a monthly training.
Yes, that's
so
right.
Monthly in services. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we all learn all mm-hmm. the time.
Yeah,
things
that's
change.
Great. So, Wendy, if somebody knows that they need skill, like mm-hmm. PT or nursing, who would they call?
They can call us. They uh-huh. call Wendy. They can call the office at 223-1478. That's sweet as
that's
a
minute.
Thanks, Wendy. I'm just sorry. I'm on United Personal Care
yeah.
Track. United Home Care is 223-3866.
Right, and that's for the Medicare.
Yeah, that's for the Medicare
data.
Home
right.
health side.
And then
ours
is
223-1478.
1478. So you can call either of those numbers, actually, and end up talking to the right person because they are in the same building and they can change. So,
right.
ladies, thank
right.
you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
We're going to go to break now, and then we're going to visit with another healthcare person, Ms. Ann Platt. So stay tuned.